Hello, my name is Eric Schwartzkopf. Today we'll talk about fracture toughness of metals. Fracture toughness testing helps determine a material's suitability for use in a wide variety of industries, from oil and gas to aerospace to civil engineering. I like to think about fracture toughness as a measurable value when the crack grows catastrophically. There's two fuzzy ideas in that sentence. What does measurable value mean, and what does catastrophic mean? Different fracture toughness tests focus on different measurable values and make different assumptions about the test. Common fracture toughness tests for metals include crack opening displacement, or CTOD, stress intensity, or a K parameter, and the J integral. Other materials such as fiber reinforced, polymer matrix composites might be more interested in a G value or a Gibbs free energy value when looking at delamination. Most researchers and engineers are interested in mode 1 cracks, or cracks that are opening in tension. But researchers for some other materials, such as polymer matrix composites, also study mode 2 shear response. Most fracture test researchers are interested in critical values such as K1C or J1C, but a crack resistance curve, a KR curve or a JR curve, is often of interest when the test doesn't quite meet all the assumptions of the desired parameter. For example, a K1C test assumes that we can ignore most of the plastic deformation at the crack tip, that a majority of the energy required to grow the crack is elastic. It assumes that most of the material that is cracking is constrained and can't see the surface of the specimen. This typically means the specimens are thicker and most of the material is in a plane strain condition. If the test specimen is too thin, you can still create a KR curve, which might be useful for design or quality purposes, but the test will not provide a critical value in mode 1 because too much of the material is unconstrained by the surface of the specimen. The unconstrained material is in a plane stress condition. Today we are running a K1C test in displacement control on aluminum 2024 T351. We are using a compliance crack length measurement technique to monitor the crack length during the pre-cracking, and this pre-crack will end when the crack is approximately halfway through the specimen. Now that the test is finished, we see from the validity results that the measured KQ value is indeed a valid K1C result. One of the complications of fracture toughness is that you really don't know if the validity criteria will be met until after the test.